It's a nice contrast. Ciao guys and welcome back, and if you are new, my name is Luca, thank you to be here. And in today's video, I would like to explain you how to properly expose Vlog to get really clean images. Really often I get the question, hey Luca, how do you get such a clean images out of Vlog? And the answer is pretty simple. I always overexpose my footage by at least one or two stops. The reason why I'm doing that is because you have always to protect your shadows while filming with a logarithmic gamma curve. And this applies both with Panasonic, Sony, Canon, every type of log footage. One of the biggest mistakes you can make is that you are exposing considering the exposimeter of your camera. So even if the camera is saying that you are overexposed by one stop or two stops, maybe you are not really protecting the shadows, because there is where the noise is gonna hide in your footage. If you like to film just with your camera like I do without an external monitor, there are two ways to properly check the exposure of your log footage. The first and the most efficient way is to use a false color LUT. In this way, you can properly monitor if your shadows are crushed or if they are well lit and protected from noise. And if you don't have it or you don't know how to make a false color LUT, I will put a link in the description where you can download it for free. And while you are going down, if you would like to support the channel, click the like button, I will really appreciate it. The second way to properly monitor the exposure of your footage is to use the zebras that you can find in your camera. The first zebra that is set for the skin tones is set to 55 IRI. And with this one, I'm pretty sure that the main subject is probably exposed, so I'm not gonna have noise in the face of my subject. While I set the second zebra to 85 IRI. So in this way, if I want to protect the highlights or the sky, I can always check if I'm clipping the highlights or not. I think it's more important to have always your subject properly exposed. And don't forget that you can always use light modifiers. In this case, I'm not using it because it's just a vlog, but you can always use light modifiers to properly expose everything correctly. Another important tip I can give you is to always stick with native ISO while filming in Vlog. Just forget about auto ISO, never use it, because there is where you're gonna have a serious problem. So try to always stick to ISO 640 and ISO 4000. And if you need to do minor adjustments, I would say that for the lower gain, you should stick around 640 to 1000, while for the second gain, you should go from 4000 to around 8000 is still acceptable. I wouldn't go further those values because there you start to see noise. And one more time, don't forget you can always use light modifiers. Another good way to avoid noise is to film in 10-bit instead of 8-bit, because you cannot really grade and push the exposure too much in post-production with the 8-bit codec. So when you can, always film in 10-bit. The last tip I can give you is that you should prefer to film your videos with the full width of your sensor, so filming with the full frame. That way you're gonna use 24 megapixel instead of the 8 megapixel from the APS-C crop mode. So filming with the full frame, you're gonna compress the noise in a way that is gonna be way less visible than filming with the crop mode 8 megapixel video. There is actually another way to avoid noise while recording internally in your camera, and that's to avoid the high frame rate options. So it's always better to stick around 24, 25 and 30 frames per second and avoid the 50 or 60 frames per second, because you're gonna subdivide the 150 megabits per second between 60 frames instead of 24 frames. And that way you're gonna have less color information and you're gonna get probably more color noise. So I hope that the video was helpful, and it's pretty cold here and I finished my warm tea. It's time for a wrap. Thank you for watching guys, and I'll see you next time. Ciao.